I'm the
head of Volga region in
my speech will continue the actual subject of Svetlana Antonovna has started. This is with reduction losses in modern demographic situation. The pregnancy is of value, and the value increases by day. So the support, the outcome of pregnancy is very important. To reach that, we also face such issues as chronic endometritis. It is important because of its inflammatory factors, but functional changes in endometritis that are always inevitable and that are the causes of such complications of endometritis that we are facing and that contribute to reproduction problems, infertility, failure, realization, reproduction technologies, and creation, unfavorable environment for neoplastic processes. That the different methods are presented to treat endometritis. We recently performed analysis of modern Russian and foreign materials been studied. Many technologies have been studied. We wanted to use one method as combining bacteriophagotherapy and combining ozone. Why do we use these two methods? Because positive properties of ozone therapy is of importance, and this was discussed recently. Bacteriophagy is one of the most precious treatment methods. It's effective used in medicine, was gynecology. We could use these two methodologies and to combine them together as on bacteria to overcome the changes that are in the nitric. Before we perform clinical effort, we try to experiment in vitro with fiber cultures and ozones in different concentrations. We defined a couple considered three-way cooperation between them. The intermediate variant is that when they don't affect each other, and the last one is when ozone could deprive factors as a strong oxidative agent. Why did we need that? We need to understand the sequence, the parallel sequence, or step by step. Well, the results we had and the methods we implemented, the popular people factor complex, it was very popular. It's a combination of sterile filtrate, stabilizers, staphylococcus, and everything that is on the screen. The coping factory process and pharmacological description of the experiment. We performed evidence analysis of bacteriophagus after combining mixing them with ozone-9 physiological solution prepared in different concentration of ozone oxygen solution. We use those concentrations of ozone higher than 150 microgram per liter. So we didn't try to actually to see the threshold when you meet the deprivation of the factors. We learned that when you use the solution, the solution of up to 10,000 concentration, we didn't see the deprivation of the factor activity. We also didn't see the efficacy increase. It was a dream, but it means that we could already use and combine those methods, and they don't contradict one another. These are the conclusions
we have the clinical studies, more than 100 patients who studied. Was covered by backed up clinical studies, didn't have any. Well, one of the factors, infertility, extracorporation, and embryon replacement, genital infections. We treated patients with chronic, unspecific, chronic endometritis. What did we find in those patients? Those microorganisms, which those plaques were infected in the first group, we implemented reactive phagotherapy. Ozone. Their microflora was characterized by stability to antibacterial leukemia. The second group that used traditional antibacterial therapy showed sensitivity to antibiotics, which methodology we did use in our practice as a physiological solution. 500 milligrams per liter after ozone therapy. We administered 4 to 7 liters of microphagic, and then the tampon was inserted into the vagina to achieve local effect. We didn't limit ourselves to enter this concentration was proven to be successful in inflammatory process gynecology field. The course of treatment included some procedures. After the discussion, after 4 speeches, my colleagues from Belgrade will implement this method today. 50 patients, as you mentioned, received traditional treatment for the complex of medicaments that Donald Polina told us, because without this, it is impossible to achieve the effect of the treatment, because such issues have to be treated. The control method, we used traditional methods, chemical research, and the mithri.
Here I focus on the hair or immunologic and bacteriophagotherapy, not talking about lipid peroxide or oxidation in lipids, and there are a lot of publications on that. If you want, you can learn more about them. As for the results, speaking of chronic inflammation processes and some severe dynamics of clinical presentations, there is no such thing, because of the clinical presentations are not very well shown. If we're talking about the normalization of the microflora, we achieved it after the ozone bacteriophagotherapy, 90% of patients, but in the compare group it was different. There were different results, they were low. Here is a culturing from the cavity of the Elvis. It's for the endometrium. In 86-90% of patients, there was high hypoplasia of endometrium and lower visualization of the spiral arteries, which points to bad blood circulation in the basin of the Elvis arteries. And without this blood circulation, of course, as you know, there is no adequate transformation of the endometrium, and it cannot be prepared for implantation. In arcuate radium, basal arteries, the parameters of the blood circulations were changed in most patients. Ozone-bacteriophagotherapy followed the pulse index in the following way. We see a significant decrease in that value after the ozone-bacteriophagotherapy, and there were no changes in the traditional approach. As for the resistance index in the bacterial arteries, you can see the in the arteries you can see there. Here we also see a normalizing effects also as compared to the traditional methods. Another proof of the efficacy of the ozone-bacteriophagotherapy is the normalization of the blood circulation and visualization of spiral arteries who in patients who had received the ozone-bacteriophagotherapy course. Of course, the result here, the most important thing is that the thickness of the endometrium in patients who have had received this therapy was within the normal parameters. In the immune histochemical picture was one of the ways to diagnose chronic endometritis. So this trend was quite clear and quite significant. In the left, we see the data before the treatment. On the right, the data in the picture of the intermittent after the ozone bacteria phagotherapy. There is case on the left and there is order on the right. The expression of the receptors of progesterone shows an even distribution before the treatment and their normalization after the treatment. The estrogen receptors, here we see the same, the trend is clearly seen. As for the values, well, let's talk about figures. Before the treatment, we see most patients with low expression to estrogen and progesterone. Later, it's 20 to 22% who had a stark expression to progesterone and estrogen as compared to the control group, where we see the prevalent number of patients with low expression to progesterone and estrogen. In the storm of so the number of such patients had gone up, and here we can see a stark tendency to grow as compared to the control group, where after the treatment there were no practically, there were no changes. The same happened in the endometrium stroma. You can say that the combination of ozone therapy procedures and the methods are quite clear. If you want to learn more about the mechanism, then they have a positive effect on such parameters of patient's blood, the blood circulation, and more for functional characteristics of the endometrium. Combined with the simplicity and availability, I guess it also shows that this method is easily reproduced and it can be used in practical work. And of course, the results that we have here, that Tatiana mentioned, according to their work, this data is not full now, it's still under analysis and on the in the upcoming forums of ozone therapists and gynecologists and obstetric specialists. These results will be presented when the data is, has been analyzed. Thank you very much. Colleagues, questions? To Gennady Olegovich. It was a very, it was a great speech. The technique is great. If you have any questions to your colleagues, we can talk about it later. Well, I have two questions. As a gynecologist to gynecologist, what would be to the optimum concentration of ozone here? Well, not having, in the interest of time, I couldn't talk about it, but of course I'll answer it now. Mr. Povedinsky, God rest his soul, showed that the concentration of 5,000 micrograms per liter is a limit for endometrium. That's safe for it. 26 years ago, when we were just starting to work with ozone therapy in obstetrics and gynecology, the utmost, the issue, the most important was the safety of our methods. And our colleagues from the Moscow Institute, who and Mr. Popdinsky was there, and he said, they said that this concentration is enough. Speaking of IV infusions, we were guided by our own experience, but in this case, we were guided by the opinion of Mikhail Popdinsky, this great scientist. It's enough. If you ask me why we ozone fags and not ozone and fags separately, of course, when you have finances for that and if you have enough time, we could have, you could has structured this design of this investigation in another way to see how they work separately, but our goal was to increase the effect of fangs or to sum up their effect, and this is what we got. Speaking of the hemodynamic effects, of course, the impact of zonal fangs is needed because patients, infected patients need antimicrobial therapies, not traditional antibiotics. We give them fangs with targeted action. Oh, I cannot take any time from the other speakers. Thank you very much, and I will answer one. I have one more question. I will ask it later. How did you get endometrium? Right after the course.